we shall reflect on the life of Saint Gall. Saint Gall was born about the year 486 at Clermont in Auvergne, France, of a rich father and of a mother who was descended from the family of Vettius Agapitus, a Roman who suffered at Lyons for the faith. They both took special care in the upbringing of their son, and when he came of age, they proposed to have him marry the daughter of a respectable senator. But Gall, who had by then resolved to consecrate himself to God, withdrew privately from his parental home to the monastery of Cournon, where he earnestly prayed to be admitted there amongst the monks. The abbots refused until he should have obtained the consent of his parents, which he readily did, and thus renounced the world to embrace a life of religious poverty. Here, his eminent virtues distinguished him in a manner that soon attracted the notice of Bishop Quintain, who prompted him to holy orders. When the bishop died in 527, Gall was appointed successor, and in this new position, he became known for his humility, charity, and zeal, and above all, for his patience in putting up with all injuries. Being once brutally hit on the head, he showed no anger or resentment towards his assailant, but by his meekness disarmed the savage of his rage. At another time, a priest named Evodius insulted him, but the saint, making the least reply, went out to visit the churches of the city. Evodius was so touched by Gall's meekness that he prostrated himself at his feet in the middle of the street, seeking pardon. From then on, they both lived on terms of the most cordial friendship. During the last few years of his life, Gall gave himself up for the upbringing of his nephew, who went on to distinguish himself as Saint Gregory of Tours. Saint Gall, who was favored with the gift of miracles, died about the year 553.